The thing is, just quickly, we're talking about the cabs, the state of the trade, losing lots of vehicles. January 2018, Lawrence, if you was a London Black Cab, from the 1st of January, you only could buy an electric, okay? The private hire could still carry on buying diesel taxis, right? Euro 6, which are the cleaner diesel engines you can get, right? At this moment in time, I've done an FOI request. There's 9,000 diesel taxis and 42,000 diesel minicabs. And yet, like we spoke earlier, whenever there's that lazy journalism on ITV or BBC and it says about pollution killing people in London, they use the same old screenshot of a row of cabs driving up a bus lane. If you was mayor, would you look at maybe allowing the black cab trade to start using the ultra clean diesel vehicles?
Absolutely.
If one could be developed.
We're in unprecedented times, right? The most important thing now is to go, we have to slightly put aside all of our utopian greenness. I really think it's important that we have a, you know, no one wants to live in a dirty city. I ride a motorbike, I have black snot in my nose whenever I get off things.
Yeah, no one does, no.
I get it, no one wants to live in it, but we are living in unprecedented times. Everybody from, you know, a social worker to a taxi driver to an actor to anybody, they need to be free and nimble to get back to work. That's the most important thing, and everything that needs to be put into that. That's it. And everything else goes on hold until people have, you know, refilled a bit of their coffers. You know, it's been a year of being absolutely brutalised.
Yeah, exactly.
That's what we need. It's great. It's all very well Paris Climate Accord. I get it. 2030, you want to be carbon neutral. That's 50 billion quid a year we're spending on that. China doesn't even have to stop reducing their pollution until 2030. If it's global warming, it's a global effort.
Yeah.
That's what I think.